Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss about the new drug application, that is also known as a NDA. So in DRA in third unit it has given in the syllabus, NT Hyderabad syllabus. So what is NDA actually? For the third year students, it is very much new topic. They might have heard this name in pharmaceutical jurisprudence also. So here I will try to give you some basic idea of what is NDA, what is ANDA, and how what is the role of this into the pharmaceutical field. Actually, NDA is nothing but new drug applications. As the name indicates, new drug application. So whenever the new drug will be searched by the different scientists or researchers, if this particular chemical entity or chemical substance is having so and so activity. So the person who is the sponsor for the particular drug, they have to go for the NDA filing, right? So before coming to the NDA filing, there will be the three steps: the preclinical study, clinical study, and NDA filing. So in preclinical study, or the drug will be tested onto the animal body, then the clinical study, the drug will be tested into the human body. And then the sponsor will go for the NDA filing to the FDA, Food Drug and Administration Department, for the approval for the marketing, right? So in here we are going trying to learn NDA. What is NDA? Actually, NDA is the formal final step taken by the drug sponsor, which involves applying to the Food and the Drug Administration, that is now called as the FDA, to get approval required to market, right? Because every new drug has to be taken approval from the FDA for the marketing. This particular new drug, it is fulfilling all the safety, quality, and effectiveness parameters. So now it can be prescribed by the physicians, or it can be marketed into the pharmaceutical market. Right. Another thing is NDA, the main terms, NDA, ANDA, abbreviated new drug application, means a abbreviated new drug application, it is for the generic drugs product, right? It is not for the main drug, it is for the generic drug product, because they are not required to include preclinical, that is the animal study, and the clinical, that is the human study data, to establish safety and effectiveness, right? Whatever the patent expired drug or this drug which we are going to for the marketing purpose, so that comes under the abbreviated new drug application, the generic new drug application, the generic drug, right? So here already into the main or original drugs, the preclinical and post-clinical data has been submitted to the FDA. So here they are not required to include the preclinical and the clinical data to establish the safety and effectiveness. Directly it will be filed for the marketing of the drug, right? So what is the main objective, what is the motto of the NDA? Whether the drug's proposed labeling is appropriate and what it should contain, that has to be confirmed when you are going to file the NDA. Whether the drug, which the drug is new drug, whether the new drug is safe or unsafe, and effective or not effective in its purpose, use, and benefit of the drug outweigh the risk. Whether the drug is fulfilling the safety parameters, quality parameters, or effectiveness parameters. The third objective of the NDA is the whether the methods used, whatever the process has been used in manufacturing of the new drug, to controls used to maintain the drug's quantity are adequate to preserve the drug's identity, drug's strength, drug's quality, and the drug's purity, right? So these three things has to be confirmed. That is the objective. The different forms which is used, documentation in the filing of the NDA, because the sponsor is going to apply for the new drug application, the form FDA 356H. This form is the for the application to market a new drug, biological, different biologicals, vaccines, sera, or many more, or an antibiotics drugs for the human use. For the human use, whenever it is going for the human use, form FDA 356H has to be filed. The second one, form FDA 3397, that is the user-free cover sheet, that has to be compiled. Third one, form FDA 3331 or 3331, new drug application field report, whatever the field report has been there for the new drug, that has to be compiled into the form 3331. Fourth one, impurity in drug substances. What are the impurities? Are possible impurities may be there in the new drug substances. The fifth one, required specification for the FDA for each and whatever the drug master file is there, that for each and every master file specification is required, and a refusal to files, right? So these are the requirement form has to be compiled and fulfill all the details about the new drugs before filing to the FDA, right? So now here it is the nothing but approval process. Approval process of the person who is the sponsor or who is the owner of the new drug which has been researched, which has been the finding is the very much suitable for the particular types of activity. So it cannot be directly marketed. It has to be go in the proper way to the FDA with all the online filings. Then FDA committee will be going to check the all the parameters, quality parameters, safety parameters, everything they are going to check on the base of the preclinical and the clinical data submitted to the FDA. When they will find this all the parameters is fulfilling the minimum standards, so they are going to either they can refuse the file if it is not fulfilling the quality parameters, or they can accept the file. Then after that it can be launched to the market for the marketing purpose, right? So again I will tell, this is not the complete notes here. I am trying to give you the idea to understand what is the NDA, what is the ANDA. Further, you have to refer the books and other sources for exam point of view. Thank you. All the best.